Hand surgeon Erica Taylor sees health problems related to smartphones every day.
So the hazards that I see as a hand surgeon in regards to smartphone use include things such as carpal tunnel syndrome, flexor tendonitis, and also a particular type of wrist tendonitis called decurvans tendonitis, which affects some of the thumb extensor tendons.
But what's really causing those aches and pains?
So I've seen texting, I've also seen certain addictive games, such as Candy Crush, Jelly Splash, can cause people to really use their thumb extensors and flexors over and over and over again. And a lot of times they do it until there's a lot of swelling, a lot of pain, and then that's when they come to see me.
So when is it time to see the doctor? Probably when it starts to hurt.
Pain is subjective. Everyone comes to me at different levels. Some people come right away, and it's just basic education at that point. If it's to the point where they can't grip, they can't lift their young children anymore because their tendons are inflamed, then they may ask me for a cortisone injection. That's how I know it's pretty severe.
Smart devices may also lead to sore or cramping fingers, neck strain and back pain from bending over devices, as well as eye strain and dry eye syndrome, something that used to be found mainly in older patients, but is now finding its way to the younger crowd.
What used to be a very frustrating condition to treat is dry eye, and made more so by our use of smartphones, computers. It's an occupational hazard when we have a profession where we do a lot of reading, a lot of high-intensity work where we are not blinking adequately, both in terms of blink frequency, but also quality of blinking has gone down as well. We even train ourselves to not blink as rigorously. And as a result, we're seeing these glands in the eyelid become obstructed.
So what's a smart device user in pain to do?
Some of the recommendations in general for overuse syndromes is to stop overusing the activity that's causing it. So maybe take a break from repetitive motion, maybe change the way you're holding your device. After you decrease frequency, if you still have symptoms, there are hand therapy modalities that we employ. Those can be anywhere from stretching to ultrasound modalities. And then for more invasive options, people come to me either for cortisone injections, and then usually the last resort is a surgical procedure.
And how to keep that eye strain at bay? Well, this doctor recommends forced blinking.
Where you would clench your eyes closed as hard as you could, you know, once or twice a day. And some people actually have an app put on their phone or their computer that reminds them to do this on an hourly basis.
And pay attention to your symptoms.
My experience is that these devices are fairly addictive. When you're in the zone, you may not notice things are bothering you. But when you do normal outside of the device activities, such as picking up things, throwing a ball, playing sports, if your wrists are swollen, if they hurt, if you can't extend your fingers anymore because they click and lock, you should probably see somebody.
So, in a nutshell, if you feel the pain, it's time to see the doctor. It's the smart thing to do. Just ask your device. Kelly Bowman, CNN.